Hi, Daniel.
Hi.
Have fun.
Well, hello and welcome to my session. In this presentation about industrial AI, I want to show you that AI really can push productions to the next level of efficiency and that AI can be a big lever in productions. The thing is that many companies are having a very tough challenge with bringing AI to the shop floor and scaling AI over their factory and also over their whole enterprise. And we at Siemens, we have the technology to bring AI to the shop floor and to scale. But, well, let's dig right into it. And I think it is no secret if I tell you that AI has already penetrated countless things in our life. So we have personal assistants helping us with, responding to our user commands. We have recommendation systems. You know this from the online stores where, based on your previous behavior, the system tells you, okay, what would be the best fit for your next purchase. We have ChatGPT, which has been on the news for the last few weeks. I don't want to tell a lot more about it, and many, many more, like autonomous cars and so on. And so it is no wonder that AI has also made it to the shop floor. And, well, to introduce in the topic of industrial AI, I have two different use cases for you, just to show you what industrial AI can look like. And the first use case comes from electronics production. So SMT production, where electronic components are soldered onto a circuit board. And at the end of each production line, we have what is called an automated optical inspection. So a system taking a picture with a camera, and then it analyzes based on different parameter settings if the part is okay and not okay. At this stage, it is without AI, and at the moment, we cannot replace this process with AI. However, this system tells you that usually around 70% of the parts are okay, and 30% of the parts are not okay. And those 30% have to be inspected manually by an operator. So an operator goes through all the circuit boards and tells you if the parts are really not okay. And the problem is that 95% of those parts turn out to be okay. So only 5% of the parts that are inspected manually are really an error and have to be taken out of the process. So to show you the dimension, I have a circuit diagram. So showing you in green, the 70%, what we call the first pass yield. And then we have in the other part, which has to be tested manually. And only the red circle or partly part circle is a real error. And then comes another point, which makes things even worse. When an operator goes through all the different circuit boards, there's a 30% chance that he misses to detect a real error. This is what we call the slip rate. So circuit boards, which are in error, but they go through the rest of the process, which then increasingly cause costs. And this is where AI comes in. So what we can do is we can connect with the AI, with the optical inspection system, take the data, and an AI model then, first of all, reduces the amount of parts to be tested by double-checking and also optimizes the quality of the optical inspection. And using AI in this case, could help us to reduce the amount of parts to be tested, reduce the number of pseudo-errors by 50%, and also increasing this first-pass yield by 15%. So overall, depending on how many lines you have, this is a six-digit cost reduction in your production. But as I said, just one use case for industrial AI. Let me give you a second one. Second use case for AI comes from a milling machine. And sometimes it is necessary that you mill out components out of a circuit board. And this milling process causes very aggressive dust. And this very aggressive dust leads to a sticking of the central bearing of the spindle. And I think you all know what it means if there is a sticking of the central spindle. You have a machine failure, an unplanned failure, which makes things again worse. You have to replace the spindle. You cannot produce anything. So you have a total mess. And with an AI, we could connect with the milling machine, so we could analyze, in the end, the vibration behavior and detect anomalies 72 hours in advance. So the AI system continuously analyzes the milling spindle, the vibration, and then tells you, hey, something is going wrong here. And then you can react 72 hours in advance. You don't have an unplanned downtime. You can prepare all the parts that have to be replaced. And, well, AI can also make a big, well, a big saving for you, up to 30,000 K a year for each single machine. The thing is, so AI brings up huge value to companies. But the thing is, industrial AI is different from the classical AI we know from the private sector. And that's the point here. There are many things in industrial applications that are different. For example, usually you have to integrate with existing systems. It's not a standalone solution. You have to integrate with under controls, with MES, whatever. Then the data quality. It's much more noisy in the production environment. It's, you don't have so much control. It's more unstructured. So this is another thing that is special for industrial AI. Then it's also reliability. If an online store goes offline, well, might be annoying. If Netflix goes offline, might be annoying. It wastes your Friday evening, but it puts no life in danger. This could be very different for industrial AI applications. So we have to be very careful. And this brings me also to safety and security, not just cybersecurity, because AI models sometimes make wrong predictions. It's in the nature of those data-driven models that sometimes they make wrong predictions. But we must make sure that those wrong predictions, they don't put anybody's life in danger or simply stop the production. So this is what we also have to do with industrial AI, make sure that it's safe and secure. It must be reproducible. In the industry sector, we are used to having reproducible use cases. If you do this for machine number one, let's think about a milling machine, you are expecting the same results for milling machine number two. But this is not necessarily the case for AI applications. So there might be different results. And now comes the last point, and this is the biggest point. It's scalability. So what does it help you if you have a single use case that brings value to you, but you cannot scale it over your factory, over your over enterprise? This is the problem many companies are having at the moment. Many POCs, many use cases that show the value of AI, but they don't know how to scale. And this is where the Siemens technology comes in and our expertise. Maybe when you walk through the different booths here, you could see on the screens a very similar architecture showing, well, in the end, the convergence of ID and OD. So you have the OD level represented by the field devices, the sensors, the controls. You have the ID level represented in this case by the cloud. And we have this, you could call it the glue layer, which is the edge. And this is not just the convergence of IDOD that it's showing, it's also a very nice architecture to scale AI. And let me get a bit more concrete on that. So what does it mean for AI? Using an edge device, so in the end, the edge device is a small computer that you have physically in your shop floor environment. It's a small computer, and you can run, for example, connectors on this edge device, extracting data from controls, from any system you would need. Then on this computer, you can also pre-process the data, you can run the model, and then you can send the prediction, the optimization, whatever, to your app, or to any device you would like, or to any system. And this edge device, it's also connected to the cloud environment, and this is convergence IDOD, so you can constantly upload the data into the cloud environment and then maintain your model, because like any application in the industrial environment, you also have to maintain industrial AI application. For example, have a look at the quality of the predictions of the model. And sometimes we have something that is called a model drift. So the results of the model of your AI application are not as accurate as they were at the beginning. And this results, well, in, or this requires a retraining, what we call it. So you have to retrain your model, host a new model on the cloud. You could actually host any model in the cloud and then remotely deploy it. And a system like this has many, many advantages if you want to scale AI and scale it over your whole enterprise. And two major points that I want to highlight here are that each single device can be a client. So you can have many use cases on this edge device or on many edge devices in your factory. They are client to the centralized cloud. And, as I said, the cloud is centralized. So today, many companies are having data scientists and experts on their shop floor, and they are trying to bring the value. But with this architecture, you can have a centralized department as a central function taking care of the models remotely. So you can have a data scientist team somewhere in the world taking care of the AI use cases. So these are the two big points that are really important if you want to scale AI applications. And of course, at Siemens, we know that you cannot, well, solve all the challenges of our customers on one slide. And this is why we say you don't just get our software, our hardware, and so on. We also offer you consulting where we, together with you, and maybe you can remember Jan's presentation, where we can consult you on the overall strategy, break it down into single projects, do the implementation, and we could also take over the operation if that's something you would need. So we highly adapt to our customers' needs in this case. And if you want to learn more about how we, well, bring AI to the shop floor, how we scale it, how we set up AI models, we have a booth right over there. So booth number 49, it's called Improve Your Operational Effectiveness with AI Services. I am looking to very fruitful discussions, and well, I invite you to come over and talk to me or to our experts. So thank you very much for the attention.